Logan, everyone. Marcus here. I review stuff. Today, I'm reviewing the song Ode to the Mets by The Strokes. This song comes as a request. In fact, a lot of people have requested this one. So anybody who has kind of followed the channel for a while knows that I pretty much just randomize the songs that I listen to. I throw them all into a Google Sheet, hit the randomize button, and whatever pops up, that's what I listen to. So that's what I usually do. For this one, I decided, you know what? It's cutting to the front of the line. Everyone has been asking for this song. I've gotten so many requests for it. So I'm like, all right, I got to do it. I got to put it to the front of the line. I got to give the people what they want, you know. So far I've listened to a few songs by The Strokes on my channel, and I've really been enjoying them. I think one thing I've mentioned that has really surprised me about them is just the great guitar work. I wasn't really expecting that going in. Weirdly enough, my first encounter with Julian Casablancas was in The Voids, actually, and so now to kind of go back to The Strokes, and I know that this album is their newest album, it's been definitely an interesting ride, so I've definitely been enjoying it, and I look forward to hearing this one. So here we go. Ode to the Mets, The Strokes, probably one of my most requested songs in recent memory. Let's give it a shot.
Learned all your tricks, wasn't too
Oh man, that was too short. I feel like I need more. That was a hell of a song, and I can see why so many people requested it. I felt that song, you know. I felt it in the melody of the guitars, and I felt it in Julian's performance there. I mean, wow, what a great song. I love that. I loved the sort of the main riff throughout the song. That did not feel like almost 6 minutes of my life. That felt like 2 minutes. I felt like I need so much more from this song. I cannot wait to listen to this one again. But first, let's break it down like we always do, of course, starting with the lyrics. So, let's see, on Ode to the Mets, the final song on The New Abnormal, Julian looks back at the band's career and history in New York City, where he grew up, where they grew up together. Bleak, quiet guitars and synthesizers back the track's verses, while full strong instrumentation comes in with the track's outro. I love that, and what a great way to explain it, leaving the listener with an epic outro to The New Abnormal. Wow, I feel like I really need to listen to the whole album now in its full context, and really see where this falls in the whole album. And I've listened to a few songs off this album so far, just based on what you guys have requested. But yeah, I really do need to feel like I do need to go back and listen to the whole thing now. Wow, this is this was a treat. Let's see, a little bit more information here. Additionally, the song begins with the same chords during the chorus, this time on the synthesizer, as previously heard on the album's opening track, Adults Are Talking, thus serving as the beginning and end of the journey. That's pretty cool. I haven't heard that song yet, but I have gotten some requests for that one, so definitely going to have to get to it now. In episode 2 of the band's podcast/video chat, five guys talking about things they know nothing about. That's cool. The band discusses this track. The New York Mets are a major league baseball National League team. I knew that much. Based in Queens, New York, and have not won a World Series since 1986. Okay, I kind of also had an idea. I know of the Mets, but I always felt like they were maybe overshadowed by the Yankees, and I guess that explains why they haven't won a World Series since the 80s. Julian calls the Mets the team of his youth. Julian wrote the song while waiting on a subway platform after the Mets had lost a painful Game 7 against the San Francisco Giants for the 2016 National League wild card. So it's sort of like, I guess, revisiting that nostalgia. Like, this was my team. For me, it's like it's the 2000s San Antonio Spurs. It's like that is the team of my youth. And if I were to write a song, it'd definitely be Ode to the Spurs. I mean, I like the current team, don't get me wrong. But like, you know, those 2000s with Tim Duncan, Manu Ginobili, Tony Parker. For a few of those years, also David Robinson. I mean, man, that was like my team, you know. Anyway, let's see, where was I? Julian wanted to remove the Mets from the song title, naming it Ode, only to be talked out of it by Fabrizio Moretti and the band, who love the song title. The band views the name as symbolic, with the Mets representing something that you set your heart to that continues to disappoint you. Ouch, I see. So maybe Ode to the Spurs wouldn't be appropriate, because they definitely impressed me with their play and their championships and all that stuff, so maybe not. The track was debuted at their New Year's Eve 2019 show at the Barclays Center in New York, New York, connecting the song further to New York. Okay, so really, I mean, it could be Ode to the Mets. Ode to New York would be, I think, another appropriate title. But let's take a look at the lyrics and see what we come up with. So, up on his horse, not gonna wake up here anymore. Listen one time, it's not the truth, it's just a story I tell to you. Easy to say, easy to do, but it's not easy. Well, maybe for you. Hope you find it, hope that it's good. Hope that you read it, think that you should. Cuts you some slack, and as he sits back, sizes you up, plans his attack. As I was listening to the lyrics, I wasn't really sure what they were talking about, and I'm still not too sure. Da da da, and then I really actually like this part. Drums, please, Fab. and I got it all waiting for me. So, like, I know I'm talking about the lyrics, but instrumentally, I love this build-up here. At first, it almost didn't feel like the synthesizer and the guitar were playing nice together. It was sort of weird at the start, but I loved this part where he was kind of, like, talking, and then he goes, drums, please, and the drums kick in. I loved that, just from an instrumental standpoint. I had to get that out before I forgot. And I got it all waiting for me down on the street, but now you gotta do something special for me. I'm gonna say what's on my mind, then I'll walk out, then I'll feel fine. Yeah, I'm under his thumb. I'm on his back. I will not show my teeth too quick. I needed you there. I needed you there, but I didn't know. I didn't know. Go alone. I'll go alone. We'll go alone. I'll go alone. Back from his trip, he's at the door. When he gets back, he's on the phone. Innocent eye, innocent heart. No, it's not wrong, but it's not right. Innocent time out on his own. Not gonna do that. Fuck, I'm out of control. I was just bored playing the guitar. Learned all your tricks. Wasn't too hard. So I can kind of see how maybe this is about their band. And so maybe this is where they got their start, just being sad, being depressed. I mean, I don't know. I'm really trying to take something away from the song, but I'm just not sure I understand how everything kind of fits together. Let's see. There's actually some more information here. In August 2010, Julian told press that he wanted to write a new theme song for the New York Mets. I'm totally serious. I have some ideas. I have to see if they like it. I've got a jar stuffed with songs, all these ideas that are just me humming into a recording device. While not keeping a tone typical to sports theme songs owed to the Mets, maybe Julian finally fulfilling his dream to create a song in honor of his favorite baseball team. Okay. It's the last one now, I can promise you that. I'm going to find out the truth when I get back. Gone now are the old times, forgotten time to hold on the railing. The Rubik's Cube isn't solving for us, old friends long forgotten. The old ways at the bottom of the ocean now has swallowed. The only thing that's left is us. So pardon the silence that you're hearing. It's turning into a deafening, painful, shameful roar. So I could definitely see how this part might be like about the band where, you know, kind of looking back, it's like, you know, we're again, those old times are gone now. We've moved on and we're different people on the other side, you know. But yeah, like I'm not sure how the lyrics play together here. I think if I had read the lyrics without reading this part over here, and especially if I had no idea who the Mets were, I feel like I really wouldn't understand this one. Only with this context can I kind of see, like, yeah, you know, it's about disappointment. It's about growing and changing, and I kind of see that. But again, without the added information, I'm not sure if I would have really read it that way at first glance. So lyrically, though, I think it is very interesting. I think I enjoyed it. There were some lines in there that really made me smile, chuckle, and just also hit me emotionally. So for sure, I give this one 2 thumbs up lyrically. On top of that, the performance here was, to me, fantastic. I loved the synthesizer there at the beginning. Like I said, it was kind of weird to me at first because like I was getting the guitar in this ear and I was sort of getting the synthesizer in this ear, and it almost felt like they didn't really interact together the right way. Like they were on two different time signatures, and so at first I was like, okay, this is kind of weird, but then eventually that synth faded and you kind of got into the main riff of the song, and that was super enjoyable. Again, at the top of the video, I said that I really do enjoy the Strokes for the guitar work, and I feel like this song was very solid on guitar. That guitar riff just really hooks you in, and it hits like with emotionally. Again, I felt like at the end I felt this song. I was like, I don't know what it's about, but damn if I didn't feel something from listening to that. So I think that says a lot to just the way they were able to perform with their instruments, that they were able to just make me feel something even if I wasn't entirely sure what was going on lyrically. So fantastic work there. I loved the drum work as well, especially, again, I like that little interaction there where it's like, drums please, and he comes in and he's playing the drums, and it definitely added a little that nice extra layer at the right time to the song. So that was really cool. But yeah, fantastic song instrumentally, and then of course with Julian Casablancas, I think he did a fantastic job. Again, his vocal performance really made me feel something here, and I've heard him before where he's singing a very high pitched tune. For me, this one he's definitely more he's lower, and it's almost like he's almost spoken word at some parts. But then when you get into sort of the full instrumentation of the end of the song, and he's really kind of singing it, he sounded so good. And his vocal performance, again, really made me just feel something. I don't know what it is that I'm feeling. I don't know if it's awe or what, but just his vocal performance, the instrumental performance, it just packs so much emotion into this song that I think as I learn more about the lyrics, and I'm sure as you guys tell me more in the comments, I feel like it's all going to come together to just be that sort of gut punch song, but in such a good way. So instrumentally and vocally, 2 huge thumbs up here. I loved it. I would give it more thumbs up if I had more thumbs. And then as far as replay value goes, like this is an instant playlist for me. In fact, once I'm done with this video, I'm probably gonna do a few chores around the house. This is definitely the first song that I'm gonna listen to while I get to work. So fantastic work by these guys. And really, this has made me even more excited to listen to the rest of the album, because everything I've heard off this album so far has been really solid. Between this, Brooklyn Bridge to, Brooklyn Bridge to Metro, what is it called? Brooklyn Bridge to Chorus, that one, there we go. I've heard that one. I heard Selfless recently, which I thought was fantastic. And then this one, Ode to the Mets. And then I recognize a few of these just from y'all's requests. So I'll have to check out The Adulterer Talking for sure. And then some of these other ones as well. So yeah, fantastic job by these guys. Two big thumbs up across the board. Really loved it. Thank you so much for all the people who had requested this one. Like I said, this was probably my biggest request in recent memory. Just so many people coming into the comments and requesting this song. So if you want to be one of those people in the future, just put it in the comments and I'll be sure to get to it. If you enjoyed the music as much as I did, you should definitely go support the artists. You should go listen to their music wherever you can. And one place you can definitely find this song is going to be in my Spotify playlist. It's in the description below, and it has every single song I've heard so far on my channel. Of course, if you want to support me, just all the normal stuff you do on YouTube, you know, like and subscribe and comment. All right, guys, that's going to be it for me. Hope to see you on the next one. Bye for now.